video today, I'll be showing you how to make a skirt in 10 minutes. Before we get into the video, I just want to say thank you so much to subscribers of this channel, all the likes and all the wonderful comments. You are going to need your tape measure, your sewing thread, pair of scissors, a curved ruler, your fabric which is jersey and stretchy, okay? I just got 1 meter here which is 50 inches wide. You're also going to need an elastic which I have pre-measured to my waistline measurement plus 1 inch sewing allowance. You're also going to need your chalk, some pins. And these are the measurements required. Your waist round measurement, your lower waist measurement which is about 4 to 5 inches down from your waist round measurement, your hip measurement, also your skirt length. Start by folding your fabric into four. As you can see, I have put a line here, a straight line where I'm going to start measuring, making sure I've got I'm starting from a straight line, okay? And make sure this is the stretchy part of the fabric, okay? Right, so we are going to start with the waistline. My waistline measurement I'm going to be using today is 38. So I divide that by 4 and I'm going to get 9.5. Okay? So I measure 9.5 here. Then mark. Okay? Right. I'm going to come down the width of my elastic. Okay? My elastic is 2 inches wide, as you can see there, okay? So I'm going to come down 2 inches and mark all the way and draw a straight line. Okay, so I'm going to draw another straight line coming down here, okay, to that line. Why am I drawing this? Because when I'm finishing off the skirt, I'm going to attach the elastic here, okay, and then fold it in, right. So it means I'm going to measure another 2 inches down from here, okay. So you measure 2 inches again. And mark, and then square another line. Okay, so that's basically your waistband for the skirt done. For the lower waist measurement, I'm going to go down 4 inches from the waistline measurement, okay? So I go down 4 inches here and mark. And then I go ahead and square another line. My lower waist measurement is 44 inches. Divide that by 4, I get 11 inches. So I'm going to measure 11 inches here and mark. Okay? The next thing I'm going to do now is to do the hip measurement. Right? My hip measurement is 7 inches from the waistline. So this is my waistline and come down 7 inches, is down here, okay? So I'm going to square another line. Okay. My hip measurement is 50 inches divided by 4 is 12.5. Okay, which takes this whole quarter of the fabric to the end. As you can see, it's exactly 12.5 inches, right? With this type of skirt, you don't add any sewing allowances because the fabric stretches a lot, okay? So the stretchiness of the fabric is going to take care of that ease and everything, okay? So now I'm going to measure the skirt length. Mine is going to be 25 inches. So I'm going to measure 25 inches from my waistline, okay? And then I'm going to draw another line. Okay? And then I'm going to add half an inch for hemming allowance. So I'm going to go ahead and draw some lines here. You may not be seeing them on the screen, but that's what I'm doing. I'm doing the skirt length plus the hem allowance. Okay. The next thing I'm going to do is to shape the skirt. So from the waistline, I'm going to join to the lower waistline. Okay, with my cap ruler. And then from there, I join it to the hip line. Okay. And then I'm going to go in 2 inches so that I can shape the skirt. At the bottom, you don't want it to be a little flared, so I'm going to come in 1.5 to 2 inches. I think I'm just going to come down 1.5 inches, okay? And then go ahead and shape the skirt like this. Okay, can you see the skirt is already shaped up, out now? Okay, so now I'm just going to go ahead and cut it out. Next thing you're going to do is to open up the skirt pieces. There should be 2 of them, okay? Right? And then with the right side facing, you're just going to stitch on the sides of the skirt and then complete the hem with a zigzag stitch. So that's what I'll be doing now. Okay, as you can see, the skirt is done, the sides are joined, and the hem is done using zigzag stitch. Okay, you can use a serger if you have one. Very simple with the zigzag stitch because it can allow the stretch of the fabric without snapping any thread. Okay, so that's the skirt done. The next thing you are going to do now, get your elastic, which is pre-measured to your waistline plus 1 inch. Okay, just overlap 1 inch of half an inch over each other like that. Okay, and then just stitch joining elastic together to make like a loop like that, or whatever you want to call it, or a circle. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do now. Right, so I've marked this elastic into 4 equal parts, this that you can see here with the chalk markings. Okay, right, I've done the same with the skirt at the waistband. So what I'm going to do next is to match those points, making sure this is my center back, the joint, okay? So I'm going to pin it, okay? Okay, that's the center front. I'm going to pin it to that as well. Then I match those other 2 markings with the side seams, opening the seams as I do that. Can you see that? So the next thing I'm going to do is just to go ahead and sew the elastic just at the edge here using zigzag stitch. You can use a serger if you have one, because the serger, the zigzag allows the stretch as you put on your skirt. Okay, I've joined the elastic to the waistline now. I hope you can see the zigzag stitch I was talking about, okay? Right. So, the next thing you are going to do is just to fold it in. It's just going to act like a self-made waistband. Right. Take that. So, there we go. The skirt is done. With a self-made waistband, as you can see, when you fold it in, and then the hem is done, and that's it. 10 minutes, you've got your skirt, as easy as that. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and if you liked it, just give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to this channel if you're watching me for the first time, and thank you very much, and God bless you. I'm going to try it on, so you can see.